What you're hearing is the sound of a fumarole, which is surrounded by sulfur on the southwestern slope of the still-active Mount Griggs volcano. The valley below a mere century ago was once filled with these fumaroles, more than 10,000 in fact, having formed as a result of the largest explosive volcanic eruption of the 20th century, where 31 cubic kilometers or 7.4 cubic miles of lava, rock, and ash were ejected from the Novarupta volcano. The specific reason why this fumarole still exists is that an active magma chamber still exists underneath Mount Griggs several miles down. Yet, the magma underneath this volcano is not currently of too much concern, as instead, a volcano we can see in the distance known as Trident has fairly shallow magma which we can worry about, as it did not exist at such shallow depths until a mere 11 months ago. This magmatic intrusion has pushed up a section of ground overlying the volcano by 2 inches or 5 centimeters in that time, being centered on its southern flank. Although we do not know if this intrusion will result in an eruption, it is surprisingly plausible that this volcano could erupt for the first time in many years in 2023. The Trident volcano is one of 13 stunning active volcanoes located in the magnificent 4 million acre Katmai National Park and Preserve in Alaska, which generally contains more bears than people, 2,200 grizzly bears in fact. This park and its numerous volcanoes are located in the northeastern stretch of the Alaskan Peninsula, with the closest populated place to the Trident volcano being the tiny settlement of Karluk, 52 miles to the southeast. While Trident is indeed in a very remote part of the state, it is still considered to be a high-threat volcano by the U.S. Geological Survey. The reason for this rating is that its eruptions have been universally explosive, and if it were to erupt, the potential would exist for regional air traffic to be greatly disrupted. The slowly upward-moving magma is seemingly centered near the Trident volcano's southwest cone. This magmatic intrusion appears to involve a deep source which is continuously sending molten rock shallower into the crust from a depth of approximately 30 miles. Not long after the intrusion began, in late August of 2022, the magma reached a joint area where 5 separate active volcanoes are connected at depth. The magmatic intrusion of undetermined size has since begun in August of 2022, seemingly moved in 3 directions. One direction was towards the northeast where the Mount Katmai volcano and caldera exist, which, although magma has seemingly stalled several months ago in my opinion in that direction, has still resulted in an increased number of earthquakes ever since, possibly due to interactions with the volcano's hydrothermal system. Magma seemingly made more progress towards the southwest, where it interacted with both the active Mageik and then Martin volcanoes. Beneath and between these two volcanoes, there have been 289 volcano tectonic earthquakes in the past 14 days, where magma has seemingly gotten close to, but not yet interacted with any of their existing magma chambers. The third direction magma seemingly moved was the most significant, as it resulted in an upward motion underneath the section of the Trident volcano, meaning magma actively exists at less than a depth of 5 kilometers or 3 miles. Trident's edifice in the past 2 weeks has been the site of 157 earthquakes, which is many times higher than is typical for this complex. Yet, what was of particular interest are a series of quakes that struck 2.5 miles northwest of its main cone, seemingly close to the Novarupta volcano at a depth of 3 miles, which have only been observed at heightened levels since May of this year. These earthquakes are not typical volcano tectonic earthquakes, but rather what are known as low-frequency earthquakes. Per a direct quote from the U.S. Geological Survey, long-period, or low-frequency earthquakes are caused by cracks residing as magma and gases move towards the surface. They are often seen prior to volcanic eruptions, but their occurrence is also part of the normal background seismicity at some volcanoes, and their occurrence does not necessarily indicate that an eruption is imminent. If the rate of these low-frequency earthquakes continue to increase, then so does the chance of a volcanic eruption occurring in the short term, probably at the Trident volcano. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.